Hi, my name is Roy Seidenberg, and I'm a board-certified dermatologist. I practice general and cosmetic dermatology on my office on 5th Avenue and 61st Street at Central Park Dermatology. Well, I enjoy teaching. I'm an assistant clinical professor at the NYU School of Medicine, and for every week for over 10 years, I've been teaching the residents general dermatology, as well as certain cosmetic procedures. Teaching certainly keeps me up to date on the latest and getting challenged by my very bright students, who are now my colleagues. We practice general and cosmetic, and generally we consider the general dermatology as the problems that people come in with are not relating to their looks. They might have a rash, they may have some eczema, they may have a growth, and of course, very importantly for skin cancer, it's very important and as a dermatologist to do a good skin check and find these suspicious lesions so they don't cause any problems later. We can also look at the skin as a whole, where we may pick up signs of other systemic diseases and find them in that fashion. And of course, a skin exam is quick and painless. Where the cosmetic dermatology is mostly appearance related, and so usually we're dealing with the face, although certainly we can deal with the hands or the neck, and we're talking about wrinkles and brown spots and folds and the appearance and the texture of the skin. And some of the cosmetic is focused more on our appearance and kind of usually reversing some aging and just looking a little bit better. Well, the advantage of seeing a board-certified dermatologist is that besides our 4 years of medical school and our years of internship, we do a 3-year residency or longer completely focused on the skin. And of course, when we're doing Botox and fillers and chemical peels, it really is all about the skin, and that's our specialty. So we can deal better with the patient's history of the skin, side effects of the skin. And of course, we always recommend a full skin examination because we can learn about the patient's health, and it would be a shame to give them a cosmetic treatment and to ignore a skin cancer growing on them somewhere else. So that's the advantage of a board-certified dermatologist, that we can really get a look at you, your sense all over, and of course take your medical history and make sure we have the right patient and the right procedure for you. So Botox is probably our most common cosmetic procedure, and part of that is because it's so simple to do, relatively speaking, and there's very little downtime and people can go right back to work. So for example, if we wanted to do our frown line, we would inject about four to six little injections into the muscles that cause the frown line. We would have the patient just hold pressure to minimize a small chance of bleeding. Bleeding for Botox, because we use an extra small needle, is very unlikely. So we have a patient hold for a few minutes and they pretty much can go right back to work, realizing that it will probably take 3 to 4 days for it to kick in. Whereas some of the fillers are a little bit more involved, that we may apply a numbing cream beforehand because there's a little bit pain involved with some of the fillers. And so we can put on a numbing cream beforehand, we can give the patient some ice, and then and if even needed, we can do like a dental nerve block. Then we would inject the filler, the substance itself, under the skin. And there may be a little redness or swelling, which could last a day or two. And then the black and blue is a possibility. If it shows up right away, it may last 3 to 4 days. Some black and blues actually can show up in 3 days and last up to a week. So the black and blue would be the main side effect. And since certain fillers are actually thicker than other fillers, and those fillers usually last longer, but we have to use a little bit bigger needle, so it's a little bit more chance of a black and blue from happening. But for most fillers, especially on the upper face, the upper cheek folds, most patients very often can go to work the next day and maybe require a little bit of makeup.